السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهداه وبعد. All praise is indeed due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us all and to give us all every reason to smile inshallah. Beautiful verses of the Quran we have listened to tonight. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant every single one of us acceptance. As we commence this evening's tafsir or this evening's lesson, I'd like to make mention of some bad news that came to me this evening as we were about to break the fast. One of the grandmothers of the community that I come from has passed away, and the news that came to me brought sadness to me, and I'm sure it will bring sadness to every single one of us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant her Jannah inshallah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant all those who passed away today Jannah. And all those who passed away in this month of Ramadan, Jannah. And all those who have passed away from our families as well as from the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever they've passed away, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant all of them Jannah inshallah. The topic is very closely linked. The last day and the day of resurrection, those are the most serious days. It is reported in the hadith that the last day, the day when everything shall come to an end, will be a day when not a single person will be believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dictates that even if there is one individual saying Allah, Allah, Allah will not destroy the world. Allahu Akbar. So when there is not a single person mentioning the name of Allah, that is when Allah's anger will overtake the entire creation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really grant us protection from that particular day. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that He is definitely going to gather us for the last day, the day of Qiyamah. Allah says in Surah An-Nisa,
الله لا إله إلا هو ليجمعنكم إلى يوم القيامة لا ريب فيه.
Indeed, it is He, Allah, none worthy of worship besides Him. He is going to gather all of you on that day. There is no doubt in that. Subhanallah. We don't doubt it. In Surah Saba, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وقال الذين كفروا لا تأتين الساعة قل بلى وربي لتأتينكم عالم الغيب.
The kuffar, the disbelievers, they said, we will not be resurrected. There's not going to be an end. The life is going to continue. Allah says, nay, tell them by my Rabb, by the one who created me, by the one who takes me away, by the one who sustains me, we are definitely going to be gathered for that particular day. May Allah make that day easy for all of us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us how close it is. Listen to the opening verses of Surah Al-Anbiya.
اِقْتَرَبَ لِلنَّاسِ حِسَابُهُمْ وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مُعْرِضُونَ.
Indeed, the hour of reckoning has come very close to man, and yet man is turning away in oblivion, forgetfulness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us mindful of the fact that there are two types of qiyamah. The first qiyamah is the day we die. That is the minor qiyamah. Then the major qiyamah is the day we will be resurrected, the last day, the day of judgment thereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all, inshallah, security on that day, and may He have mercy on us on that day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there are many people who are asking you questions about when the hour is going to be. Tell them that the knowledge of the hour is with your Rabb, with Allah alone. He has not enlightened anyone regarding that particular hour. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ahzab.
يسألك الناس عن الساعة قل إنما علمها عند الله وما يدريك لعل الساعة تكون قريبا.
They are asking you about the hour. Tell them that the knowledge of that hour is with Allah, the Creator Himself. And how do you know? It might be very, very close, Allah says. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. The fact that we have had a final messenger is a very strong sign of the hour. Because after the final messenger, there are no more messengers. When the messenger said that there is going to be a messenger coming after me, the people could relax a little bit to say at least the world is not going to come to an end. But when you are told that I am the last of all messengers, you should know that that means the next stage is the end of everything. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, even in Surah Al-A'raf,
يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ أَيَّانَ مُرْسَاهَا قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ رَبِّي.
They are asking you about the hour. When is it going to be sent? Tell them the knowledge of it is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it will only come suddenly. It will only take people by surprise, unexpectedly. Allah says, we will not inform you in advance. Yes, there are signs which will lead to that particular hour for those who know the signs. To be honest, there are minor signs and major signs. All the minor signs have already taken place. Allah says, and subhanallah, the Mubarak lips of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have uttered the signs of Qiyamah, the signs of the last hour. And believe me, if we were to go into that topic, we would see that most of the minor signs have already occurred. We are now waiting for the major signs. Not that we are happily waiting, but really we are worried. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to prepare for that day. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-An'am,
قَدْ خَسِرَ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِلِقَاءِ اللَّهِ.
Indeed, those who have not believed in the meeting with Allah are at loss.
حتى إذا جاءتهم الساعة بغتة قالوا يا حسرتنا على ما فرطنا فيها.
Then when the hour comes to them suddenly, they will then say, oh, you know, we are at loss regarding what we did in the past. We didn't do any good deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us from those. And Allah says,
لا تأتيكم إلا بغتة.
Clear verse in Surah Al-A'raf. The hour will come to you suddenly. It will take you by surprise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nahl, powerful description.
وَمَا أَمْرُ السَّاعَةِ إِلَّا كَلَمْحِ الْبَصَرِ أَوْ هُوَ أَقْرَبُ.
The command for us regarding the hour is like the blink of an eye. Allahu Akbar. Allah says like a blink of an eye, or even closer than a blink of an eye. Before you can blink your eye, everything can be finished by the will of Allah. He says that command of ours is a click. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Allah is showing His power. Then Allah says, look, those who are calling out besides Allah, partners, associating partners with Allah, Allah says, when the punishment comes to you, or when the hour comes to you, when the hour of tremor comes to you, who will you call out to? Will you call out to your partners, or will you call out to the Creator, Allah? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who don't associate partners with Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-An'am,
قُلْ أَرَأَيْتَكُمْ إِنْ أَتَاكُمْ عَذَابُ اللَّهِ أَوْ أَتَتْكُمُ السَّاعَةُ أَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ تَدْعُونَ إِن كُنتُمْ صَادِقِينَ بَلْ إِيَّاهُ تَدْعُونَ.
Allah says, ask them a question, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that do you see if the punishment comes to you, or if the hour has to overtake you, are you going to call out to anyone besides Allah to alleviate the pain or the calamity? Allah says, nay, you will only call out to Allah on that day. In fact, verses we read tonight regarding sincerity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about even those who don't believe in a God. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when they are at sea on the ship, they still call out to a God, Allahu Akbar, because they know that here in the middle, when the boat starts rocking and we are in the middle, even if we can swim, we cannot swim 200 kilometers to shore. We can probably swim maximum 2 or 3 kilometers really. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So Allah says,
فَإِذَا رَكِبُوا فِي الْفُلْكِ دَعَوُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ.
When they ride the boat, when they are in the middle of the sea, then they call out to one Allah. They say, O Creator, O you who is the owner, O you who can protect us here, ensure that we get to the coast, ensure that we get to the coast. Allah says they call us sincerely. They never associate partners because they know their idols will drown with them. May Allah protect us. And Allah says, as soon as they get to the coast, they begin worshipping their idols once again. They forget what happened. I think sometimes it would be more appropriate for us to give the example of an aircraft. As we are about to take off, the levels of sincerity automatically increase. Subhanallah. When there is turbulence in the sky and the aircraft is bouncing one after the other through the clouds or through the wind, Allahu Akbar, you find people saying, La ilaha illallah. The sincerity with which they utter those words is unmatched. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us sincerity, inshallah. Then when they come back onto the ground, they forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet they were close to the friendship with Allah. They were almost walis in the plane. May Allah protect us. Allahu Akbar. Really, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us sincerity. Allah says that, what are you waiting for to turn to Allah? What is going to make you repent? What is going to make you straighten your ways and habits? Are you waiting for the day the angels come? Are you waiting for the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes? Allah says it will be too late. Anyone who has not believed by that time, it's not going to help them. And anyone who believed but did not do good deeds, the good deeds will not help them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-An'am,
هَلْ يَنظُرُونَ إِلَّا أَن تَأْتِيَهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَوْ يَأْتِيَ رَبُّكَ أَوْ يَأْتِيَ بَعْضُ آيَاتِ رَبِّكَ.
Are they waiting for the day the angels come, the day that Allah comes, the day that the signs of Allah come, the major signs of Qiyamah come? Allah says,
يَوْمَ يَأْتِي بَعْضُ آيَاتِ رَبِّكَ لَا يَنْفَعُ نَفْسًا إِيمَانُهَا لَمْ تَكُنْ آمَنَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَوْ كَسَبَتْ فِي إِيمَانِهَا خَيْرًا قُلْ انْتَظِرُوا.
Allahu Akbar. Allah says, on that day when the signs have come, when Allah comes, when the angels come, those who had not believed yet, it won't help them on that day to say, now we believe. It's too late. And those who did not do good deeds, Allah says, it will not help them on that day to say, let me quickly do good deeds or let me repent. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. And Allah says, regarding the signs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of the fact that there are signs that will lead up to the hour in Surah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
فَقَدْ جَاءَ أَشْرَاطُهَا فَأَنَّا لَهُمْ إِذَا جَاءَتْهُمْ ذِكْرَاهُمْ.
Indeed, the signs have already started coming. The signs of Qiyamah began to come. They have come, Allah is saying. And I told you, one of them is the very sending of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The prophethood of the last prophet is already a sign of Qiyamah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really to make us truly from amongst the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes what is going to happen on that day. And I've decided to tamper with the order a little bit because there is something very serious about to come. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, on that day, we will solve all the problems. Anyone who had any dispute, the truth is going to come out. Anyone who cheated, they will be made bare. Anyone who lied, who deceived, they will be made known. Everything is going to become manifest. Anyone who had a problem, who did not resolve it in this world, we will resolve it, Allah says. And Allah says, on that day, no wealth will help you. Nothing will help you. No connections will help you. No status will help you. Nothing besides justice and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Yunus,
إِنَّ رَبَّكَ يَقْضِي بَيْنَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فِي مَا كَانُوا فِيهِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is definitely going to judge in the disputes that had taken place between them on the day of Qiyamah. Allah will be the judge and He will resolve all the matters very, very quickly. And Allah says, we will put a scale of justice on that day. In Surah Al-Anbiya, Allah says,
وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ فَلَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا وَإِن كَانَ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ أَتَيْنَا بِهَا وَكَفَى بِنَا حَاسِبِينَ.
Allah says, on that day we will put up the scales of justice and we will bring forth absolutely everything. Nobody will be oppressed even if there is a mustard seed weight worth of any form of action, Allah says, we will bring it and we will put it onto the scales. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tip our scales towards goodness and never tip them towards evil. Now comes the description of that day. Allah says, on that day we will ask a question.
لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ
Who does this day belong to? Who wants to talk on this day? And Allah says, there will be no sound. Dead silence. Nothing. You won't hear a sound. And the response will come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ
This day belongs to Allah, the one, the irresistible Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the owner. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection on that day. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about this in Surah Al-Fatiha. We read it so many times. Allah says,
مَالِكِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ
He is the owner of the day of judgment. The supreme king of the day of judgment, the one who owns absolutely everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even the day that he decides to blow the trumpet, it's his ownership. He decides. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-An'am,
وَلَهُ الْمُلْكُ يَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ
It is Allah's kingdom, the day that he decides to blow the trumpet, subhanallah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides that the trumpet shall be blown, it will be blown. And listen to what happens. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ
And the trumpet shall be blown and absolutely everything shall be destroyed into pieces besides that which Allah wills, subhanallah. Everything will be destroyed when the trumpet will be blown. It is known as the day of the loud scream in Surah Abbas. Allah says,
فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَّةِ
The day that you will hear a loud yell, a loud noise, a loud scream. Everybody will be screaming. Everybody will be yelling. There will be chaos. People will be running from side to side. Allah calls it subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says,
فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الطَّامَّةُ الْكُبْرَى
In Surah Al-Nazi'at, Allah says, on that day there will be a huge catastrophe, huge calamity. Allahu Akbar. Allah's anger will overtake absolutely everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes every single creature. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hajj at the beginning.
يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا
The day that you shall see the end.
تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ
Every female who is pregnant shall miscarry automatically because of the sound, because of the screaming, because of the yell, because of the disaster, because of the calamity. They will be miscarrying.
يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا
In fact, the first part of that verse, Allah says, every female who is breastfeeding shall forget what she is doing and start running. Allahu Akbar. Imagine the closest bond you can have is when a female is breastfeeding, the bond between herself and that suckling child. And Allah says she will forget what she is doing, stand up and rush and run for her life. Allahu Akbar. And Allah says after that,
وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى
People will seem intoxicated, completely drunk.
وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى
Yet they will not be intoxicated in any way.
وَلَأَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ
But the punishment of Allah will be immense, intense and severe. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. And Allah says on that day, nobody will be able to help another person. Nobody will be able to help their child or their father or their brother or anyone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that in Surah Luqman as well.
يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم.
O people, fear your Rabb. Be conscious of the one who created you, whom you are going to return to.
واخشوا يوما لا يجزي والد عن ولده ولا مولود هو جاز عن والده شيئا إن وعد الله حق.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O people, be conscious of your Rabb and be conscious or fear, be careful of the day when no child shall be able to assist meaningfully his or her parent, and no parent will be able to help his or her child. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Allah says, my promise to you is definitely the truth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to describe in Surah Al-Qiyamah. He describes what will happen on that day. He says,
فَإِذَا بَرِقَ الْبَصَرُ.
On that day, what will happen? The eyes will be dazed because of the flashes of light, of the destruction of everything around.
وَخَسَفَ الْقَمَرُ.
And the moon will be eclipsed completely. Neither the moon nor the sun, nothing shall be seen.
وَجُمِعَ الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ.
The sun and the moon will come together.
يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر.
Man will say, where can I run to on this day? He will dart that way and dart this way and dart the other way. There will be chaos. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, سبحان ربي الأعلى, in Surah Al-Mursalat, He says,
إنما توعدون لواقع.
What you have been promised is definitely going to come. Allah says,
فَإِذَا النُّجُومُ طُمِسَتْ.
The day that the stars will be dimmed completely. They will be gone, extinguished. Their function is over.
وَإِذَا السَّمَاءُ فُرِجَتْ.
The sky will crack. The sky will burst. It will start to crack. Allahu Akbar. And Allah says,
وَإِذَا الْجِبَالُ نُسِفَتْ.
The mountains that you see will actually become powder. They will be powderized with so much heat that they will be like clouds.
وَتَرَى الْجِبَالَ تَحْسَبُهَا جَامِدَةً.
When you see the mountains now, they seem to you very solid.
وَهِيَ تَمُرُّ مَرَّ السَّحَابِ.
Due to the heat of the moment, Allah says they will be moving like clouds, just dust particles in the atmosphere. Those will be the mountains you knew. And Allah says in Surah Al-Anbiya,
يَوْمَ نَطْوِي السَّمَاءَ كَطَيِّ السِّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ.
On that day we will roll the sky up like the rolling of a scroll. Allahu Akbar. Like the rolling of a scroll. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes it. Then Allah says, every single person is going to be brought forth, starting from the time of Adam alayhi salam right up to the last person.
قُلْ إِنَّ الْأَوَّلِينَ وَالْآخِرِينَ لَمَجْمُوعُونَ إِلَىٰ مِيقَاتِ يَوْمٍ مَعْلُومٍ.
In Surah Al-Waqi'ah, Allah says, definitely those who are right at the beginning and those right at the end shall all be brought together. Imagine how many people. Allah says,
وَإِذَا الْأَرْضُ مُدَّتْ.
The earth shall be stretched, a long stretch, and everybody will fit on what is known as the arasat of Qiyamah. Only Allah knows where exactly that will be. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there will be billions and trillions and quadrillions of people, all of them from the beginning right to the end. And do you know what? Allah describes it. Allah says,
ثُمَّ نُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ.
Then the trumpet shall be blown a second time and everybody will be resurrected after the end. And Allah says in Surah Al-Qamar,
خُشَّعًا أَبْصَارُهُمْ يَخْرُجُونَ مِنَ الْأَجْدَاثِ كَأَنَّهُمْ جَرَادٌ مُنْتَشِرٌ.
Allah says on that day, the people's sight will be humbled like cockroaches. They will be rushing all in huge groups of cockroaches, walking and rushing towards the caller who will be calling them. This is what Allah says on the day of Qiyamah. This is what will happen. Allah says,
وَجَاءَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَعَهَا سَائِقٌ وَشَهِيدٌ.
Every person will come with an angel who will be pulling or driving that person together with a witness. The angel who was with you all your life will come as a witness against you or for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وكل إنسان ألزمناه طائره في عنقه.
Everyone will come with a tag on their necks, the good tag and the bad tag, and we will be dragged like cockroaches, subhanallah. All the people, just imagine it for a moment, as we are coming out of our graves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we will be taken with tags. Someone will be driving us and the other will be standing next to us as a witness. Wallahi, we will be moving in order to answer in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He warns us of that day. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes it so vividly in this Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us,
يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارُ.
That is the day when the earth shall be changed with another earth, and the skies. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to say, you will find everybody gather for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, on that day,
وَأَشْرَقَتِ الْأَرْضُ بِنُورِ رَبِّهَا.
The light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will lighten the earth, subhanallah. That will be the light on that day. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really warns us in so many ways. Let's look at what Allah says about the sky itself. He says,
إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انشَقَّتْ.
That day, the skies shall be split completely, destroyed. In another verse, Allah says,
إِذَا السَّمَاءُ فَطَرَتْ وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ.
In fact, that verse belongs to the verses that I read previously.
إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انشَقَّتْ وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ.
Allah says, the skies shall be destroyed following the command of Allah, and they will indeed follow the command of Allah. And the same will happen to the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا.
On that day, there will be a huge tremor on the earth. The earth will come to an end. It will spit out everything that it has underneath, and it will straighten and flatten, and man will say, what is wrong with this earth?
وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا.
Insan, man is going to say, what is wrong here? What is happening to this earth? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes this, and he warns us. Allah says,
وَخَشَعَتِ الْأَصْوَاتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ فَلَا تَسْمَعُ إِلَّا هَمْسًا.
On that day there will be dead silence. When Allah resurrects everybody, you will only hear a slight shuffle of the feet. You won't hear anyone say one word. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that thereafter he will call. What will be the call? Allah says in Surah Al-Qasas,
وَيَوْمَ يُنَادِيهِمْ فَيَقُولُ أَيْنَ شُرَكَائِيَ الَّذِينَ كُنْتُمْ تَزْعُمُونَ.
Allah says, on that day we will call out to them, bring those who you worshipped besides me. Let's see if they can help you. They themselves need help. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. كُلٌّ يَقُولُ نَفْسِي نَفْسِي. Everybody will be saying, oh, I'm worried about myself. Including all the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, besides one, who is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And inshallah, we will get to that a little bit later, inshallah, in tonight's session. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that on that day, do you know what will happen? The sun itself will be wound and it will be dimmed and extinguished. Allah says,
إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ كَدَرَتْ.
Allahu Akbar. Allah says, on that day the sun will be wound, completely extinguished. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the same applies to the stars. They will be dimmed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and their function would have been finished. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then explains that he will come. He will arrive, and the angels will come in rows. Listen to what Allah says in Surah Al-Fajr.
وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا.
Your Rabb, your Creator, your Sustainer, the one who took your life away, the one who resurrected you thereafter, Allah, He says He will come and the angels will come in rows. How exactly that will happen, only Allah knows. We believe in what He has mentioned in the Quran and we stop there. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ.
On that day we will bring Jahannam forth. We will let Jahannam come right onto the point where we are taking account. So when Jahannam sees the criminals, listen to what happens. Allah says, Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about this in Surah Al-Furqan, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
إِذَا رَأَتْهُمْ مِنْ مَكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ سَمِعُوا لَهَا تَغَيُّضًا وَزَفِيرًا.
As the criminals see Jahannam, Jahannam will make a roaring, bubbling, crackling sound, inviting sound to tell them, this is your abode. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really make us from those who can take heed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us, He says,
وَبُرِّزَتِ الْجَحِيمُ لِمَنْ يَرَى.
Indeed, 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 Jahannam is going to be made clear for everyone who would like to see it, and it will be right there. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask, is this not the day? Did I not promise you of this day? Allahu Akbar. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that man will come. And now he will start fighting his case with Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nahl,
يَوْمَ تَأْتِي كُلُّ نَفْسٍ تُجَادِلُ عَن نَفْسِهَا.
On that day, every single person will come pleading their case, debating, fighting, arguing, trying to save themselves, to say, no, it wasn't like this, it was like that. It was like this, it was like that. And Allah will say, no, hang on, just pause for a moment. In Surah Yasin, Allah says,
الْيَوْمَ نَخْتِمُ عَلَىٰ أَفْوَاهِهِمْ.
On that day we will seal their mouths. We don't want you to talk. You are lying. You're telling us a lie.
وَتُكَلِّمُنَا أَيْدِيهِمْ وَتَشْهَدُ أَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ.
Allah says, their hands will have mouths to talk to us. Their feet will bear witness against them as to what they used to earn.
يَوْمَ تَشْهَدُ عَلَيْهِمْ أَلْسِنَتُهُمْ وَأَيْدِيهِمْ وَأَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ.
On that day, their tongues will talk on their own. Not only will the person be using the tongue will have its own tongue to speak, subhanAllah, to bear witness, Ya Allah, this person here used me in order to utter bad words, in order to utter words of kufr, words of lies, words of deception, words of harassment, words of slander, words of backbiting, words of gossip. Allahu Akbar. And Allah says, then the hands will bear witness to what you touched, what you stole, what you took, what you earned, what you spent, everything. The hand will talk. And Allah says, the legs will be speaking, the skin will talk. The skin will bear witness, Allahu Akbar. The body organs will bear witness on that day. So Allah says, look, we don't need witnesses from anywhere else besides your own organs, Allahu Akbar. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَإِذَا الصُّحُفُ نُشِرَتْ.
On that day, the books will be made open and clear. Read your own book.
اقرأ كتابك كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا.
Read your own book. You can bear witness against yourself and that is sufficient. It is your own book, Allah says. Allahu Akbar. Look at the description of this day. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells us thereafter that when the people come, their organs will be bearing witness for them or against them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us there will be definitely two distinct characters, two distinct types of faces.
يَوْمَ تَبْيَضُّ وُجُوهٌ وَتَسْوَدُّ وُجُوهٌ.
There will be shining faces on that day. And there will be faces that will be dull, in anguish, and really worried. The face of the criminals will be really darkened, Allah says. And Allah says, those who are full of good news, inshallah, may Allah have mercy on all of us, they will have faces bright, full of happiness and smiling. They will have every reason to smile. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the books will be given. Everyone will get their book and collect their book. And Allah says, very quickly, He will sort the taking of account. Very quickly. Allah says,
فأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه فيقول هاؤم اقرءوا كتابيه.
The one who will be given his book on his right hand, he will go out and say, hey, read my book, I've got my book. I've got my book, come and see, I've got a good book.
وأما من أوتي كتابه بشماله,
as for the unfortunate one who was given the book in the left,
فيقول يا ليتني لم أوت كتابيه.
He will say, oh, I wish I never ever got my book. I wish I never ever got my book. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says,
ويوم يعض الظالم على يديه يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا.
There will be large groups of people who will be chewing on their hands and trying to bite their hands in regret. Those will be the ones who had bad company in this world. They will be cursing themselves to say, Ya Allah, why did I take such and such a person as a friend of mine? They led me astray. They did not remind me when I was going wrong. They did not remind me regarding my duties to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's a lesson for all of us. Let us vet our friendship inshallah. And let us eject those who are not fit enough to be our friends. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us assets to those around us and to those who have befriended us or those whom we have befriended. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He will invite people to make sujood after He uncovers a part of Him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
يَوْمَ يُكْشَفُ عَن سَاقٍ وَيُدْعَوْنَ إِلَى السُّجُودِ فَلَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ خاشعة أبصارهم ترهقهم ذلة وقد كانوا يدعون إلى السجود وهم سالمون.
الله أكبر. Allah says He will invite people to prostrate to Him. Those who did not used to prostrate in the dunya will not be able to prostrate on that day. Allah says, now why can't you prostrate? It is reported their backs will be stiffened and made straight. And it will be told to them, this is because when we called you to prostrate to us whilst you were in the world healthy and fit, you did not prostrate. Today, where are you going to be able to prostrate? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the sajideen, from those who prostrate at all times. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, people will want to run away on that day. And people will be cursing one another. Allah says that the kuffar on the day of qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes in Surah Al-Ankabut, Allah says,
ثُمَّ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يَكْفُرُ بَعْضُكُمْ بِبَعْضٍ وَيَلْعَنُ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا.
People will be cursing each other on that day. And people will be disassociating themselves with each other on that day. People will be swearing each other on that day. It's because of you that this happened. It's because of you that that happened. I'm not going to go into the details of this. It is too much in the Quran. Subhanallah. The regret of the day of Qiyamah is mentioned in many places in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Abbas,
يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ.
On that day, a person will run away from his own spouse, from his own brothers, from his own children, from his own family members. He will be far away, unreachable. Unreachable. He will be gone. Every single person will be worried about themselves. What's going to happen to me? Forget about the child. Forget about the father. Everyone's going to be worried about themselves. When we meet Allah, we will be alone, singularly facing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and it's amazing,
يَوَدُّ الْمُجْرِمُ لَوْ يَفْتَدِي مِنْ عَذَابِ يَوْمِئِذٍ بِبَنِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَأَخِيهِ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there will be people who not only will want to run away from their spouses and their children, but they will tell Allah, Ya Allah, leave me alone. Take my son. I've got a son. Take him. Punish him. Ya Allah, take him. Take my wife, Ya Allah. Allahu Akbar. May Allah protect us. Take my husband. Take my mother, my father. Take my friend. You see that one there? Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Allah says, that's not going to happen. But people will still utter that because they are worried, really worried. May Allah protect us. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about those who shall be resurrected deaf, dumb and blind. Though they could see in the dunya, they will tell Allah, Ya Allah, why are we blind? Why are we deaf? Why are we dumb? Yet we could see in the dunya, we could talk, we could hear. Allah says, no, you were deaf, dumb and blind. Because when we sent you our verses, our signs, when we reminded you, you turned a blind eye. You closed your ears. You never ever spread the message. You never uttered that which was good. So you were dumb for all practical purposes. You were blind. And at the same time, you were deaf. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of this point in Surah Taha.
وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى قَالَ رَبِّ لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى.
Whoever turns away from our reminders in this dunya, they will have a bad life to start with. And when they get into the akhirah, Allah says they will be resurrected blind. They will say, Ya Allah, why are you resurrecting us blind when we could see in the dunya? And Allah will say, no, when our signs came to you, you turned a blind eye. So today, we have forgotten you and you are from amongst those who won't see. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not do that to us. Then after the people will be bubbling, bursting in Jahannam, in hellfire on that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the people within Jahannam, really they will be such that every time their skins are burnt, they will be replaced with different skins so that they can taste the punishment over again and over again. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they will then call out to the people of Jannah, to the people of paradise. Allah says in Surah Al-A'raf,
ونادى أصحاب النار أصحاب الجنة أن أفيضوا علينا من الماء أو مما رزقكم الله قالوا إن الله حرمهما على الكافرين.
The people of Jahannam will call out to the people of Jannah to say, please pour some water on us or any form of goodness, any liquid you can, just pour it on us so that we do not suffer in this fire. And the answer will come, no, Allah has prohibited it upon those who have disbelieved and belied and turned away. May Allah never do that to us. Those who did not take their spirituality and their deen seriously, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says on that day, this will be the result. And so much that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes in Surah Az-Zukhruf. Allah says,
وَنَادَوْا يَا مَالِكُ لِيَقْضِ عَلَيْنَا رَبُّكَ قَالَ إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ.
They will call the gatekeeper. They will call the gatekeeper of hell. The angel who is keeping, who is the gatekeeper of hell, they will call him and say, ask your Rabb to give us death once again. And the angel will respond, there is no more death. You only taste death once. Now there is nothing called death. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never do that to us. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and this has hope for all of us in Surah Al-Ma'idah.
قَالَ اللَّهُ
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, and he will make this announcement on the day of Qiyamah.
هذا يوم ينفع الصادقين صدقهم.
On this day, those who were truthful, that truthfulness will definitely benefit them on this day.
لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه.
Allah says on that day they will have paradise. Running beneath them will be gardens, will be rivers, subhanallah, in their gardens. Rivers of all sorts. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they will be dwelling therein forever and ever. Allah is pleased with them. They will be pleased, or they are pleased as well with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this brings us to the final point. We need to constantly make dua for Allah's mercy. We need to constantly be mindful of this last day that is coming. We need to be mindful that everything is going to come to an end. And at the same time, we need to always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the intercession of the one who will be having the power to intercede by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the only creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who will be concerned about his followers. Everyone will be saying, I'm worried about myself, I'm worried about myself. And he will be saying, Ya Allah, I'm worried about my ummah. It is reported that he is the first person to be resurrected, the first to enter Jannah. And he will be sitting at a pond, subhanallah, on the day of Qiyamah, known as Hawdul Kawthar, waiting for the members of his ummah. As they pass, he will notice them from their signs. What are the signs? The shining of the places of wudu, subhanallah. And this is why it's important that we make our wudu properly. Because on the day of Qiyamah, we will be recognized by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam by the shining of our faces, our hands, our feet, and where we wash when we make wudu. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our wudu. And may we be granted the intercession of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The heat of that day is described. The disaster of the day, the calamity of the day. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, subhanallah, on that day there are several categories of people who will be known as the VIPs. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst them. There are definitely quite a few of them. But the instead of going into all that detail, let's just make a dua. Ya Allah, make us from amongst them. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallah bihamdih. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.